प्रेरकः सूचकश्चैव वाचको दर्शकस्तथा शिक्षको बोधकश्चैव षडेते गुरुवः स्मृता.
गुरु मीन्स वन हू गिव्स अस इंस्पिरेशन नॉलेज विजडम एंड गाइड्स अस टू द राइट पाथ.
गुड इवनिंग लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन. Today we are delighted to have with us an exemplary personality, Mrs. Rehmat Bhat, Madam. She is in the Karnataka Administrative Services and currently the Assistant Director, Tourism Karnataka Government. Before joining the Karnataka Government, Madam was the Deputy SP of Karnataka Police from year 2008 to 2009. In her free time, she likes to read and is also a chess and badminton enthusiast. We are blessed to have you here, ma'am, and I invite you to please kindly say a few words and enlighten us.
Well, good evening, everybody.
Yeah.
So, how are you all? So freshers. So, did you enjoy the first month in Balaji?
Believe me, he's going to talk a lot about UPSC, IAS and a lot of things. But I want to give you some real facts of Balaji.
Okay.
I have walked on this campus as a student, as a teacher. And sir has called me whatnot. I was DSP, but he has called me DIG, commissioner and many things. He used to always forget my designation. So I have walked as a student here. I have gone around, sir, like anything, like a small kid. And I have done all this jo hosting aap kar rahe ho, I have enjoyed that also. I have sat and slept here also. I have sat in the classes and studied, you know, with the books on my lap. And sir is some professor is teaching. And I'm like, okay, and still studying my own thing. So I have done all the things which you people do. At some point on Balaji, you will feel that nahi, 8 to 8 class is too much. And ye bahut sare papers hain, backlog hai, hame chutti nahi mil rahi hai. You will have all the complaints in the world. But I'll tell you, this is what is required. This is where you will be polished. We are standing here, we are able to stand on any podium, on any stage and talk to any range of people today. That's because of the society. Because I got such a nice exposure here, believe me. I was from a police background, okay, that was a different life. But here I met a lot of people from the commercial, you know, the CEOs and a lot of talks. And I know in 1 hour lecture, bahut boring hota hai. I know half of you are thinking, ke dinner mein kya bana hai yaar, kal kya karna hai, aur ye kya hai? Why are we listening to them? Abhi to 2 saal hume padhna hai. Why should we, you know, sit here and get bored? All these things will come in your mind. But trust me, the discipline, the dedication, the way sir is dedicated to his work, I was so inspired by him that I said, let's start this. Because you know what I was doing? I wanted to give my exams. So I was sitting in the class and reading my own stuff and then listening to the lecture also. So I said, kyun na ye bhi ho jaye? Because trust me, when you entered this college, you gave your MAT, CAT, whatever. Okay, you entered the college giving this small test and group discussion and your personal interview, right? Then 2 years of your own discipline, finance, marketing, HR. When you get out of this college, that is when the companies come to you, you'll have the best companies here. Sir will bring the best companies to this college, believe me. But you have to be versatile. You should know what is ISIS. You should know what is happening in Pakistan. You should be able to speak on the color blue. You should be able to speak on what's happening in Kashmir. You should be able to speak on what is NPA, what is this FDI, everything. And how does this come? Sir has given you the best, I think, on this campus. No other college in India right now is giving you what sir is giving. Okay, a syllabus which is integrated with UPSC. But many of you will say, main UPSC kyun karu? Mujhe MBA karna hai. Main UPSC kyun karu? But then after 2 years, this knowledge of yours will not harm you. You know, intellect is not born in a day. You have to, it comes over the year, over, you know, it includes all your discipline and everything. The morning breakfast you don't miss, 12 baje tak party karte ho, but morning 8 o'clock you have to come for class. this is the kind of life here. And believe me, when you get back to the corporate world, there you will be working for 15-20 hours. And this is one college which will, you know, train you for that kind of a life, whether it is. And one more thing, there is no hard and fast rule that you have done MBA finance, so you will stick to MBA finance. You can go and explore the world. When I come from a very conservative family where I didn't even know, you know, how to speak, how to interact. I come from a very simple family. But then that ambition, that bahut sare log yahan baithe hain jinke aankhon mein dreams hain, but the intensity, the willpower to fulfill those dreams, that is what makes you different from others. Okay, then I gave my state services, I got into police. I used all the weapons, I mean AK-47 se lekar, small one also. If you look at me, ye DSP hai. Ye to dikhti hi nahi, ye kisko darayegi? But isn't it? You feel like that. But if you sit down, calm down and think of making a career, not just, you know, ke mujhe ye kaam karna hai, that's it. You build your own personality and become so important to society, so relevant, as Mr. Bilal will tell you, that you have to be relevant to society. And that is how, matlab, like for example, Bala sir, when he grew, the whole institution is growing. When the whole tree is growing, the whole family is growing. Because he didn't stop, because it was his dream to bring all you here, all you people here. And every year this is happening. And I have seen so many students, where you people are missing is, when you, after finishing your 2 years, when the interviewers come, when the companies come, and they ask you simple questions, you are not able to compile everything, all what you have studied, and put it in a crisp, precise form. That is because you have neglected who? Your own self in these 2 years. What you require for this is, your newspaper is there, your curriculum is there, everything is there. But along with this, the knowledge of the UPSC, General Studies, what it includes is all the basic subjects, you know, okay, history, geography. Along with that, there is one paper, CSAT. Now this CSAT aptitude paper, which you used to get into this college, will help you to write your bank PO exam, to write your UPSC exam, to write your state exam, or to write your jo company ke tests hote hain, they give you aptitude, even those exams. So one topic, one subject is going to give you an entry to all other fields. And I was an engineer, electronics engineer. I didn't stop there. I got into police. That was a wonderful, adventurous field. At that age, it looked nice. Like Sir Farooq dekha tha. So it hit me. I got into police service. That was where I saw reality of life. Then I didn't stop there. I got out of it for XYZ reasons. I came into corporate. So corporate was one field which gave me a different view of life. Okay. Aisa bhi hota hai. Then I went back to state services again. This time I'm assistant director tourism. So what I'm saying is, you may think that she's not serious with the career, isn't it? But I find it very, very, very interesting. I mean, even I would try to get into business someday. The point is, never stop dreaming. You can do so much. And a girl like me, if I come from a very small town, okay, and where there is like, there are facilities, but the family is such that you're not supposed to do this 6-6 baje ke baad curfew and yay and wo. But you still can achieve a lot. What you have is your own time, your determination, your perseverance, your patience, and a set of books. That is what you need. Okay, and why UPSC for MBA? Why should I do UPSC? I feel why you should not do UPSC. Because you as managers, when you get into any company, knowledge empowers like anything. If you have the knowledge of every field, everything what's happening around you, not just facts, mind me, there will be a lot of people reading 2-3 newspapers in a day. Not just facts, opinion building also. You need to have an opinion on every topic. What will happen to Modi? How will Modi's foreign trips help us? What's happening to the FDI sector in India? Okay, what's happening in Middle East? You should be able to form your own opinion. And that is what This is a very grilling process. You are actually officers in the making. Okay, you need to. I know many of you are feeling, you know, ki ye relevant hoga ki nahi hame. These questions are coming in your mind. But then this knowledge will not, you know, put you down anywhere. You will stand apart. Because information and putting it in the right form and few of you will also want to give some exams. MBA, 2-3 saal baad, corporate mein kaam karne ke baad, you will feel, ke nahi, I just want to try something different. And that time you may not have the time. But this college is integrating everything and giving you. You are studying and as well studying a lot of things. So after 2 years, when you look back, you will feel, ke acha kiya, ke we read all this, all that. All the subjects that you're going to read in the next 2 years will never, never harm you. At least you will be able to guide others. And you build your personality. It does not come in a single day. Okay. In fact, we were even scared, okay, how will we talk to so many students? How will we connect with them? Because we always had an informal interaction with people. Okay, we are simple people with all our fears, with all our doubts, everything. But there is something higher that is guiding us. Okay, so rest of the thing, what happens in the service, there's so much fun in the service. And this is the first institute in the whole of India which is integrating such a thing and giving you, you know, table pay. Otherwise, there will be students जो एम बी ए करते हैं, इंजीनियरिंग करते हैं, ब्रेक लेते हैं, देन दे गो टू मे बी डेली और बैंगलोर और सम प्लेस, टेक कोचिंग, स्पेंड अ लॉट ऑफ मनी इन दैट, फूड प्रॉब्लम, क्लाइमेट प्रॉब्लम, एवरी थिंग इज प्रोवाइडेड टू यू ऑन दिस कैंपस. वॉट एल्स डू यू नीड? एंड वी नीड बेटर मैनेजर्स इन एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन टूडे. वी हैव डिफरेंट पीपल कमिंग इन टू आई मीन कोई डॉक्टर है, कोई बी एस सी से है, कोई इंजीनियर है, कोई दे आर पीपल फ्रॉम डिफरेंट बैकग्राउंड कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग टू सोसाइटी. एंड इफ वी ब्रिंग दिस एम बी ए लॉट, दिस एक्सक्लूसिव लॉट इन टू एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, इट वी विल वर्क वंडर्स. आई मीन यू ऑल्सो यू स्टडी सो मेनी सब्जेक्ट्स, यू स्टडी लॉजिस्टिक्स, यू स्टडी एच आर, यू स्टडी सो मेनी सब्जेक्ट्स. द नॉलेज ऑफ all these subjects and what it makes you as a person, if you apply that thing to administration, I think the whole machinery will move in a better direction, rather than having somebody who is from, you know, a background who is like some from science and some from. But ye jo polish yahan milta hai jo MBA colleges mein, if that thing is applied in administration, just imagine the quality of performance, service delivery, that would tremendously increase. And that's why I told sir two, three years back, and I framed this whole thing, and sir picked it up and he started this. So I invite you all. I'm not a host here, I'm not a guest here. In fact, I think I'm part of Balaji already, and I invite you all for this and be open to this idea. Okay, I want to read everything possible. I mean, any number of activities, sports hai, cultural activities hai. Don't stop yourself, you know, for anything. Ki I cannot do this, I cannot. Yours is an age where you should be, you know, even ready to digest stone. You should be able to do hundreds of things in a day. If sir says 6 o'clock you're supposed to assemble here. 10 baje tak baithna hai. When I look back, I feel really blessed that I was here, because the kind of and the fun you have, I mean, that is still there in my memory, the fun I had on this campus. So I know, and the long lectures, usme bhi maza hai, maza lo, don't complain. I have seen students at the end, middle of the year, they start complaining with everything. Just keep moving. You cannot stop here. MBA finance कर लिया, ख़त्म हो गया. MBA marketing कर लिया, नहीं यार, discover, explore. If you can't explore, invent and, you know, make it beautiful. I had a lot of limitations. Believe me, I had, you know, speaking and writing problem, even jog, running. I think I was seeing everything. But I developed myself. I wrote it down on paper. This day I am zero, but by this day I will be something. Targets, goals, achievements. Yeah, one thing I admit, I was all alone all throughout. So I could explore so many things. I'm not saying that you should stay single. You better find a better match, and that's a your personal thing. Yes, one more thing which I see is this age has this emotional imbalance which I've seen in Balaji. When I came to class to teach them, one student came with a fractured hand. I said, kya hua? I got placed. So, tumhe to khushi manani hai, you got placed. He says, main placed ho gaya, isliye sabne itna mujhe peeta, itna peeta ke fracture ho gaya. What is this? Bala sir was like, kya karein? He is so tensed, kya karein in bachon ka? He says, ye 20-22 year logon ko samalna bahut zyada difficult hai rather than criminals ko samalna. Kyunki unhone to galat kiya hai. De do third degree. Inko kya degree de? So we said, let's bring this UPSC thing. Let's tell them that there is something more serious in life rather than pyar, ishq, mohabbat and all that nonsense. There is something else that is more important. Wo sab to chalta rahega, koi na koi haath pakdi lega, mil jayega. In the process, you'll find somebody. For that, I'm very lucky because I've got a wonderful partner. He is one person who's like encouraging me for everything. In fact, he praises me more sometimes than, you know, himself. Fir main kehte hu zyada ho gaya. But in the process, you will find somebody. But making this thing your whole life and you're after it and then you get into depression, kya yaar? If you ever get into depression because of a heartbreak or something like this, please think of us who are staying in Kashmir and sometimes we don't have light, we don't have... All the ration shops are closed and there is flood. There is, 2014, floods. We had a baby in the house and the army came to take that baby out. Such harsh conditions, not only Kashmir, if you go to Northeast also, there's so much of chaos. You are actually so comfortably sitting here. So what will you do today? Please make a diary and write down all the dreams you want to, achieve. Chahe wo, even if it is going out and getting wet in the rain, na, beach mein, raste mein, please write it down. And see that you fulfill every dream of yours. Yeah, when you die, you should not feel ki maine ye nahi kiya, wo nahi. Fulfill every dream of yours. And don't stick to this, main ye karunga, wo karunga. Nahin, make a beautiful plan for yourself and work for it. And this is the age. You know, how we, kehte hai na, how we train, we catch them young and train them and wo hathiyar bhi uthar lete hain in the other world. This is the way we are catching you and training you so that you build your career. Let me be very short because it's very boring when you talk for long. And even I used to get, ki ye itna zyada main sun nahi sakti, bade bade lectures. Yeah, but with all this, you need to groom yourself. Okay, everything is there. There is on this campus, there'll be a lot of festivals. Sir celebrates Eid, Diwali equally. Jaise apna festival hai. And we celebrate it like anything. For 1 year, don't complain ki ghar jaane ne mila, chutti ne mili. Enjoy it, yaar. After 1 year, if somebody calls, you will not be able to come and sit in Balaji. They will remove you out. So enjoy this phase. I know this was very important for you people because you have still not started your curriculum. So it is very, very important that you keep this in mind that somewhere you will fall into the trap of complaints. Ye theek nahi, wo theek nahi, wo theek nahi. Don't fall into that trap because you're not going to stay here. You have to go and work somewhere else. You have to live a future somewhere else. Okay? So I will stop here and let sir continue. Thank you.
A very good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I, Preksha Sohalka, student manager of Sri Balaji Society, feel privileged to introduce our today's guest, Dr. Bilal Bhat, who is the resident of Jammu and Kashmir. He was born in Haripura village of Handwara. He is an IAS officer. He studied in village up to 3rd standard. Then from 3rd to 10th standard, he studied in Minto Circle School, Rajbagh, Srinagar, Jammu and Kashmir. He completed his 11th and 12th from Government Higher Secondary School, Jawaharnagar, Srinagar. Sir completed his graduation from Sher-e-Kashmir University of Agriculture Science and Technology, Jammu, and Veterinary Science in July 2010. He started preparing for civil services in New Delhi. Sir qualified Kashmir Administrative Services Examination in 2011 with 22nd rank in first attempt. His subjects were Veterinary Science and Public Administration. Sir did his training and posted as Commercial Taxes Officer, Department of Finance. He rendered 2 years of service in Kashmir Administrative Service. Sir also qualified Indian Forest Services exam conducted by UPSC in 2013 with 23rd rank and got Uttar Pradesh cadre. His subjects were Veterinary Science and Zoology. Sir also completed 2 years of training from Indira Gandhi National Forest Academy, Dehradun, with honors and was awarded Nilgiri Prize for excellence in essay writing by Mr. Prakash Javedkar, sir. He joined Uttar Pradesh cadre in 2015 and posted in various capacities as Divisional Conservator of Forest. Sir also gave UPSC Civil Service Examination in 2016 and got All India Rank 10th. And will get IAS with Jammu and Kashmir cadre. Not only for his work, sir is also passionate about playing badminton, cricket and football, singing and music, poetry, reading non-fictional books. Also, he has a peculiar interest in the field of physics. His achievements do not end here. Sir has also done his master's in natural sciences and wildlife management from Indira Gandhi National Forest Academy, Forest Research Institute, Dehradun, and postgraduate diploma in environment and sustainable development. We are delighted to have you here, sir. May I now invite Dr. Bilal Bhat, sir, to share his words of wisdom with our student community who are eagerly waiting to hear from you, sir. Now the dice is all yours. Thank you, sir.
Good evening, friends. Thank you so much. I am honored and privileged to be invited to such an institute. Thank you so much, sir, for inviting me here. And the one thing I must tell you that when I actually came into this institute right now, just half an hour before, from an environment point of view, it's a wonderful thing. Like, there are so many trees and greenery around. This is what we need, actually. Our campus in Dehradun, that is a Forest Research Institute, is one campus which is brilliant, like all the forest trees, and it's a wonderful campus to be. And I think this campus is also very good. Such a greenery and the microclimate is good. So you need less ACs, okay? And you will live 2 years of healthy life here. So full praise to the institution, sir. Well, this institute, when Rehmat told me that how we have integrated the UPSC preparation with the management, it's a very nice idea, actually. When we were in the college in Sher-e-Kashmir University of Agricultural Science and Technology, and we had a dream that I will qualify civil services, but unfortunately, there was no one to guide, and the whole faculty was against us that why you are preparing for civil services. So in that way, you're lucky enough. If some people are thinking of preparing for civil service examination, being in this college, all the efforts will be synergized for a particular result, that is civil services examination. So there are very few institutes in the country where the syllabus and the preparation mode goes in the direction of civil services. So it's an opportunity for you where you should work on. And if some people have an idea of giving civil services examination, they should start making good efforts, and the environment is conducive for that preparation. Actually, I was a bit confused at what I had to speak on this occasion, because on the one hand, there are people who want to go into management. Like I was talking to the duty officer, which was with me, that he has a startup and good ideas about how to make our country vibrant. So we all have dreams, and we should aspire for those dreams and work hard. I will strongly call for that we should not go for a particular field. Like if somebody has qualified civil service examination, let all follow the path and get motivated by that. We need to focus on each and every sector. We need to build a vibrant India by working out our strengths. That's all of us are different by nature and by the genetics. So explore that part which is in you for the betterment. That's how we will diversify the needs, future needs of this nation. Definitely, if somebody wants to go in the direction of being an administrator, a civil servant, then you're lucky enough to be in this college where all your efforts get synergized. So my life has been full of struggles. I come from a place which is conflict prone area, turmoil, and it's not good for neither for the business, neither for the studies. So in fact, I had not closely been the victim of the conflict, but definitely in my childhood days, there's a lot of imprinting on me of close encounters with the how army and militants have interacted, and that has a profound impact on my mind. The children out of conflict, they always are shy, and it's very difficult for them to move forward. But the dream of achieving, the dream of doing something, that was always, that engine always kept me going. So even with a humble background, I tried my best to achieve. I'm not a Norman Vincent Peale, a motivator for you, who writes books. I'm not a Shiv Khera, who writes the motivational books. I may call myself the words like determination, consistency, that willpower, the how your hard work makes you a good person. I'm the practical example of that. So it's not, there is nothing theory in my what I say. It's practical. Even I was getting success in, I got Kashmir Administrative Services. I got into IFS, I worked there. But the aspiration and the dream of being a civil servant and work in the administration and be an IAS officer kept me going. I'm married, we have a daughter this year. So it was a tussle between the aspiration and the problems. The problems maybe from my childhood, when I being from the conflict area, the issues of family, you have to take care of them also. The problems of a good coaching, because you will not find it there, no facilities. So out of that, this so much of intricacies, the aspirations have won, and that hard work has paid off. So I will just say that by determination, by hard work, you can crack any examination. You can be on the top of the world. So work hard. And work hard on what you are. Do not mimic other people. See what is the strength in you and how you can contribute to the society and for the country at large. That is the most important part of it. Motivate yourself. Each and every person has its own way of motivating. There is a motivation which comes from, it should have an internal locus of control. It doesn't come from outside. So this is a thing which you have to sort from within. You have to go to your room, find what you want to do, how relevant you be for the society. I was just discussing with Rehmat that why this institute has been doing things differently. Why don't you go for some village visits, 1 week village visits? I'm telling you, there will be so many people among you who will get motivated by the problems our villages face. Since I have come from the national academies, I have already worked in 3 national academies. So we have an interaction with the village. 70% of our people live in villages. So we have to think for that if we are thinking towards for a vibrant India. Somebody was just telling me that many army officers have come here and motivated you, and there should be an urge to do something for your country. Definitely you do. You join army or join any other sector. But first of all, there are many other things one has to keep in mind. Why don't we go to that village where from that Jawan comes who is on the Siachen border? The welfare of that village, the facilities, health, drinking water, housing, who will take care of them? You, if you want to join the service. The civil service examination is a platform for it. This service gives you a wide platform to work for the society. So if you go for a village visit of 1 week, you will tend to understand that what we are neglecting. Living in a particular metropolitan cities, 5-6 metropolitan cities, is not a reality. Reality is far bigger, and we have to explore that, what it is. So civil services, for that matter, is a motivation to work for the society and for the poor. That motivates you to work. There are so many issues and so many platforms to work for those. When you are an IAS officer, you tend to go to people, understand them, understand their problems, identify those problems, and proactively help in solving those problems. If you are sincere enough, upright, and having a good integrity, definitely you are an asset for the country. Don't feel only in a particular sector you can serve the nation. You can serve the nation in each and every time and space. Being in the Balaji Institute, you can serve for your country by being a better manager who is an asset to the country in the coming 2 years. This is an achievement for you, for your country. Do not divide our nation into a particular classes, that this class is doing good for the nation and others are not doing. Each of us have a potential. Each of us have a duty to work for the country. Explore that and polish that. And with a purpose, do your work from start of your day till you are in the bed. This makes your life complete. Each and every day of your life is important. Each and every day. Do not think too much about the future, because nobody has seen it. Live in the present. So each and every day of your life is important. Live it with full joy and confidence. George Bernard Shaw says that in a famous quote, that may you live every day of your life. We all live, but we always have a life, but living it is a different sort of experience where you become an asset for yourself, for your family, for the society, and for your country. So there are many less people who live a positive life. So work towards that for that achievement. So regarding civil services examination, I'm not sure I should go in the details of it. If somebody has some specific question, we can take on later. But there is one comparative advantage of a manager, because there's a very thin line of difference between an administrator, a manager, and a leader. Okay, so each of one can be transformed. Leadership is not a trait. Leadership is, we can do it by training, by proper guidance. The great leaders will guide you how to become leaders. And our nation needs more leaders, and you are the future leaders. As far as administrator and a manager is concerned, you have a comparative advantage. There are so many friends of mine who are from management background, and I have seen them working closely. And there is some sort of spark in them. Maybe they are inclined towards being better managers. So definitely for you, it's an advantage to be a good administrator. Once you are a good manager, and with your ideas, with a platform like civil services examination, you can put your ideas into reality, and that will make you a good administrator. And once you put your ideas, anticipate the future with a vision of for your country, you become a leader. So work hard towards being a good leader. And I think in multiple ways you can become, and civil services examination is most relevant as far as concerned, because as I see it, because we have to work for 70% of the people who are living in the rural areas, who need facilities, who need you, your knowledge, your ideas for a particular result. As far as the examination is concerned, so you all know that it's a three-stage process: prelims, mains, and an interview. So in prelims, you have got a subject, you have got a general studies paper, objective paper, and second aptitude. I hope that you don't have any problem with the second paper. You have already gone through the process through CAT and MAT. So paper first with general studies. Right now what you need is that you should have complete information about what is going around. You can make use of newspapers, you can make use of online videos, you should watch Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha debates, not Times Now and Republic debates. So it's better you go for a highly a normal debate, which is present in Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. And as Rehmat has already told, bring a clear idea and your viewpoint about issues. Let me talk a brief about this thing. To be honest, what has happened presently is that there are many narratives on Facebook, on WhatsApp, on so many social medias. We are stuck in something called, which Alvin Toffler in Future Shock says, that is an informational overload. We are suffering from that right now. And unfortunately, people who have got access to media and access to social media, they are creating more narratives. But unfortunately, we have failed to make a counter narrative, whereby an environment of positivity could be put into place in the society. The society is turning negative because of social media, because of the campaigning. So it's our duty to understand the issues, particularly national issues, international issues, where we need a viewpoint that what's going on, or we need to question the government, and we need to question the one we have elected. And we have to form a viewpoint which is rational and which is acceptable. Unfortunately, we are losing the rationale in this regard. And it's the duty of you to make a counter-narrative which is more relevant, which is more rational, without indicating anything. And it's your duty. How you will do it? You will do it by educating yourself more, by reading as much as you can from different newspapers, from the debates, your own debates, and bring out a relevant viewpoint which is for the betterment of the country. This is the one thing which you have to keep in mind. I think this is the things which I have kept in mind to speak. There are much more things and topics I can speak on, but I think if we have some sort of interaction, so that it becomes much more relevant. If there are some questions, you can ask questions about anything, so that I can answer. It will be so that a two-way communication. Otherwise, I will go on speaking continuously, and we will move in a direction, in a different direction. So this is open for the questions. If you can ask me questions, then after this session, I will complete my session.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
So in the recent days, a new paper on ethics has been introduced in the mains. So can you please share some points on how to prepare for that, yes, sir?
Paper 4 constitutes the ethics, integrity and aptitude. That is the name of the paper. So it has been introduced recently. It's a theoretical paper, paper 4. And I have scored the highest marks this year in ethics paper, and particularly third and fourth paper. I think the approach for the paper 4 should be that, first of all, for example, I left a mobile here, okay? There's one person here. I went, so my mobile is lying here. So what should a person appropriately do? There are many options for him. He will put that mobile, take out the SIM and take it. Okay. He will say that your mobile mil gaya, free ka. So there will be some other, there is another option for some people that he will come and give it back to me. So it will be the right decision. So what the ethics paper demand is, the question, case studies are like this, but what we need to transform is this simple language that ye mobile utha ke de dega mujhe is to be converted into ethical language by using the terms like value-laden elements, value-laden terms like honesty, integrity, fraternity, jo bhi ethical terms are values. So first step one should do is understand the language of ethics paper. So any term which is which ethics language is having, you should make notes of it. Take definitions, 5 or 6 lines of definition, particularly like ethics, value, integrity, temperance, patience, honesty. So many of terms are there. Once you search on a Wikipedia, you will have a Pandora box opened. Okay, there are so many terms you can. So closely take the definitions, 6 lines, 5 lines definition, and work on those definitions. Understand. Everybody will tell you, honesty kya hota hai, bata dega. But when you tell me what is honesty, when you have to write it. There is a medium of examination. Okay. You might be an ethical person and honest person, but if you will not be able to write it, communicate it in the question, in the answer, then it becomes irrelevant. So we have to first understand the lexicon of the ethics paper. So take all the definitions what you have, write them down, understand them, and then solve the case studies. Solve as many as case studies you can. Make a group. Take a case studies from online and then discuss what are the different ways you can solve a case study. What is the ethical dilemma involved in the case study? Once you will do a lot of practice, so you will be able to answer the case studies. And there are many behavioral psychologists, scientists who will give lectures on ethics. For me, it was like Mukul Pathak sir in Delhi. He's a known, he teaches psychology. So I watched his videos about, that's also available on YouTube. You can take it from there. So the first part of the ethics portion, that's a bit difficult. Like, it's difficult to understand. So what is the difference between attitude and aptitude? What's the difference between values and ethics? पहले तो एक महीना लग जाता है कि ethics और morals में difference क्या है, ठीक है? So when you make definitions, read them again and again, you will appreciate that these things are different. And once you will understand the lexicon of ethics, you will be able to write a better answer, and which is having elements of ethical language. So I think this should be done. Second is, for ethics paper, you should have a, you should be fast in writing. Look, the paper in civil service has changed. It's not a test of knowledge only. It's a test of how fast you write. First it was a test of knowledge. Then it was a test of time. Now it's a test of knowledge, time and space, because space is already given. You have a 200 word, you have to write in 200 word. Now it is space constraint. So you should be clear what you have to write. So it's not a test of knowledge only. You have to be a better manager. And Rehmat in that respect has helped me a lot. He's a good writer. She's a good writer. So she helped me a lot how to write a very precise answers. And ethics, you should always link it to the examples. That will be done by the newspapers. Once you are thorough with the newspapers, with the events which are going around, you can better interlink those examples with the ethical dilemmas and present it to the examiner that you are knowledgeable and you are well versed with what is going around. You are an educated person. So I think this will be done. There are certain books which you can, like there is Chronicle Lexicon, there are other books also. You should also go for thoughts by thinkers, I think, which here faculty can teach you better about it. So I think more writing practice, case study, solving more case studies, and the lexicon will do that.
Hello, sir. My name is Niyati Nikam, and I have given my attempt currently on 18 June.
Yeah.
So I have given my pre, and I wanted to ask you, how do I go about my optional? My optional is public administration.
Oh, great.
So how do I go about it?
I think you should have started it, na? Because
yeah, I have started it in the beginning, and then later I focused on prelims.
Okay.
And now
your prelims, it went good?
Yeah, I am expecting.
You are expecting.
Yeah.
So for public administration, there are some certain basic books you have to read. Okay? Like for thinkers, you have to go for Prasad and Prasad. For public administration book, Avasthi and Maheshwari. Indian public administration paper, second book, Rajni Goyal and Arora. Are you listening? Yeah, you're writing it down?
I'll write.
So it's like a one-to-one communication. Others are boring, like, kya ho raha hai? For thinkers, it's Prasad and Prasad. So for paper, this is for paper first. Okay, the thinker portion is the major part. Okay, once you understand, well, it is more relevant to management. Once you understand the thinkers like Taylor, Mary Parkett Foley, Chester Bernard, Herbert Simon, Abraham Maslow, Rensis Likert, okay, Peter Drucker. So once you understand these thinkers, what they have said about, you will hold on this complete subject. It's based on the principles and what these people have said and how it has evolved from classical to the behavioral theories. So Prasad and Prasad will give you a good insights of that. And another book, Public Administration by Avasthi and Maheshwari. And this is enough for two, but you can have some current topics like globalization, like new public management, like other aspects like Minubru, after Minubru conferences. You can go for Fadia and Fadia public administration. For paper second, you can go for Indian public administration by Avasthi and by Rajni Goyal and Arora. That's enough for it. For paper second, link it with the current affairs. I think I'm too fast. Yeah. You had to be very fast in the examination.
No, I'm noting that.
And since the time is less, you can take Vajiram and Ravi's written notes, handwritten notes from Rajendra Nagar, Kumar Photo State.
Yeah, I know that.
If you don't have any friend there is a site online kind of Flavido.
Yeah.
It's an yeah. You can take photo state material from there. And you can go for Mohit Bhattacharya.
Roman Saini videos.
An academy? Yeah, you can go for it. But don't waste too much time on videos. You had to apply your mind first.
Yes.
Everything cannot be spoon fed. You had to work on it. Thinkers is the most important part. Once you cover the thinkers, you understand the PubEd is done. And do a lot of practice. Okay. Answer writing practice.
Writing practice.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
for Indian Constitution books for first time readers? Books for first time readers in Indian Constitution.
Indian Constitution. I am. Yes. You need to read Indian Constitution. That is the basic book. Okay, I got it. You can go for Constitution at Work NCERT 11th textbook. Okay. Once you complete that, you can go for M. Lakshmikant by Tata McGraw Hill Publication.
Okay. D.D. Basu.
Yeah. Don't read it.
Okay. I'm confused. That's why I'm asking.
That is written by a lawyer. You have to read books which is written by a person who has failed in the civil service examination 3-4 times. He knows better about this, how to do it. Okay. So D.D. Basu is a bit difficult book. You can go for M. Lakshmikant. Okay. But start with our Constitution at Work, NCERT textbook.
Okay. And sir, what will be the correct time for go through the test series?
Once you feel that yeah you have completed the basic syllabus of geography, polity, history, economics.
2-3 months before exam is okay.
For what? Prelims?
For go through the test series.
Nahi, are you like obsessed with the test series? You want to give it? Okay. You first reach to the stage where you complete first the NCERTs, the basic reference material. Once you are like you have to write something, na? Test series is not. Okay. You are talking about prelims test series or mains test series?
Mains.
So first you should have a content. Okay. So content will come from NCERT, clearing the basic concepts and some reference books which are already on Insights on India. I have already written one essay. So you can go through the books on that. Once you after content you have understand hoga or newspaper content part, you can go for writing parts.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, I have a question, sir.
Sir.
These are MBAs. What are the advantages of civil service? Compared to
corporate. Well, I have already spoken a little bit about it. Civil services, like I was in administration first at a lower level, like state administration. Then I was in forest service. Forest service is a bit technical. Okay, it's a one department. There's only one sector you can work on. That is environment, ecology, plantation, protection of forests, wetlands, tiger conservation. All that thing comes in the wildlife and forestry comes in this sector. I was not satisfied. The reason was, you always want to have a diversified field. And there's only one service in the country which will provide you such a large podium to work on and such large issues to deal with and a highest level of interaction with the people. And that is IAS. That is the civil service exam through which you come. It's a very, like you can, for example, you can work in health department, in health sectors, you can work in education sectors, you can work in science and technology, in rural development, in drinking water and sanitation, in space. There is endless fields. So this service gives an opportunity to, like I was in IFS, I was stuck to a particular department where there is no other choice, you have to be there. But in administration, you have got multiple, like from, there is one person who is from a technical background, like he has done in engineering. So once he comes in the civil services, he becomes a generalist. And he comes to that particular department, for example, science, space and science and technology. He can work better there, understand its problems better than a person from MA economics or political science. So there is a varied field. Once he is there, and after 4-5 years he do a good work there, and then if he feels bored, he moves to another sector like health. Take the experiences he has done in science and tech, move it to the health sector. In health sector, then people work to education sector. So this is a large platform where you can work for the people. And the only thing which is common to all these things is betterment of the country and interaction and elevation of the problems of poor and services deliverance to the people. So this you will not find, to be honest, let me be blunt honest, this you will not find in anywhere. In corporate sector, it's much more a bit profit oriented. Okay. Yeah, remember this. Once you work in administration, work in these fields, first you will get let's keep aside the privileges and the powers and whatever you get. But the level of satisfaction you get in doing that, I have personally seen it. After one day's work as a block development officer, there is so much of satisfaction. Yaar, aaj maine is gareeb ko ghar de diya with some discretion. Aaj maine is scheme ki implementation kara di. I have done a good work. Do you feel? So two things come at the same time. One is the work you do for the people, and the satisfaction you drive out of it is unmatchable, to be honest. Let me tell you, it's unmatchable. That's why people aspire. From 11 lakh people apply for civil service examination, only 90 people are selected for IAS. So this is the aspiration, this is the determination, these things carry forward. That this is the motivation for me. This was the motivation. I had to go to that stage, I had to go to that platform where I can work with the people. Maybe initially I was not so much of involved, like logon ke liye kaam karna hai, desh ke liye kaam karna hai. Pehle nahi tha, to be honest, pehle nahi tha. पहले था कि बस अपना ईगो सेटिस्फाई करना है, एक बड़ा एग्जाम क्वालिफाई करना है, लाल बत्ती मिलेगी, सफ़ेद गाड़ी मिलेगी, सो दिस थिंग्स फॉर देम. बट वंस आई वेंट इन सर्विसेज, इन कश्मीर एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव सर्विस, इन IFS, देन आई रियलाइज दैट आई हैव अ बिगर रोल टू डू. मैंने देखा खुद को, मैंने खुद को जाना, मैंने झांका अंदर से, ठीक है, कि नहीं, आई शुड गो टू दैट प्लेटफॉर्म वायर आई कैन वर्क फॉर द पीपल. मैंने आई डिड अ लॉट ऑफ पार्टिसिपेटरी रूरल अप्रेजल इन द विलेज इन अमरावती, मेलगा, टाइगर रिजर्व, एंड द प्रॉब्लम्स एंड द इश्यूज पीपल आर फेसिंग, दैट मूव्ड मी अ लॉट. एंड फ्रॉम दैट डे आई टोल्ड दैट आई हैव टू गो फॉर द एग्जामिनेशन, आई हैव टू वर्क फॉर IAS, आई हैव टू कम टू दैट प्लेटफॉर्म टू वर्क फॉर द पीपल. सो दिस इज द प्लेटफॉर्म. I am again not telling you that to come here, matlab main aapko motivate nahi kar raha, nahi sabhi aa jao idhar, but this is the platform where you can do the best job for your country. You can do other, you will be doing it in other sectors, but this sector, it's unmatchable. And but once you decide, you have to go, you have to come to IAS, be sure that you work hard, be determined, and have patience, because this examination needs a lot of patience. You would have failures, but to overcome your failures, you'll come as a successful man.
Good evening, sir. Sir Devashri here. So my question is like that, from this point, if we are thinking for the IAS exam, then we don't have time now. Because we are here for MBA, we are already done with our graduation. So when I ask many people, can I do the preparation for the IAS exam, then they told me, you want more 5 to 6 years for this. So if it is right, or we can do preparation from this point and we can achieve our aim before our marriage, before our anything, because we don't have very much time. So I want this clarification, sir, because I am very confused about that. I thought after engineering for the IAS preparation, that's it.
Yeah, definitely there is a time constraint. Even when I was doing my graduation, I never matlab time hi nahi milta tha. So you can synergize. The thing is, hamare college mein it was very difficult. They will see a newspaper in the classroom, there will be some sort of memo will be given. At least that thing doesn't happen in Balaji. Okay, you are being encouraged to do it, and you can synergize this time in studying your optionals. Maybe like public administration is linked with the management, or you can take management as an option, because there are so many people who take management, and it's a very good subject. You will find you have 2 years of preparation for the management. And I'm telling you one thing, a proper planning with a dedication, I'm telling you, this is my experience. A proper planning with dedication, definitely. देखो, एक घंटे का newspaper आप रोज पढ़ोगे ना, 45 minutes. Consistency. The word is consistency. The problem is that there is no consistency. You can take 45 minutes. इतना busy होता है क्या? Can't you read a 45 minutes newspaper? क्या ये possible है? If you will promise me that you will read 45 minutes of newspaper for 6 months and see after 6 months. As a person, how you will evolve. So do it at a micro level management. Do a micro level management. This is all management. Okay. If you are busy with the classes, You can take the option like management, public administration, see the syllabus which is in sync with the UPSC syllabus. You can make notes out of it and synergize the efforts and read newspaper. You can take always 1 or 2 hours a daily. And you have holidays on Saturday or Sunday, whatever. I think you don't have holiday, that's good, yaar. So you're involved always. Itna difficult nahi hoga management jitna 5 saal ka veterinary sciences hai. So a lot of practicals, a lot of study. So aap believe nahi karenge that I had a proper planning through that. Main aata tha, veterinary sciences tayar kiya, 5 saal tayar kiya. ठीक है नोट्स बनाए और मेरे नोट्स अभी भी मार्केट में बिक रहे हैं वेटनरी के ठीक है आई एम नॉट गेटिंग एनी रॉयल्टी ओके द थिंग इज दैट मैंने सिनर्जाइज किया आई थॉट कि वेटनरी साइंसेस 5 ईयर्स मुझे मिल रहा है लाइक आपको 2 साल मिल रहे हैं मैनेजमेंट तैयारी करने के लिए एंड आई यूज टू टेक लाइक मिनिमम 1 आवर रोज में टेक्स्ट बुक्स पढ़ता था ज्योग्राफी की पॉलिटी की हिस्ट्री की स्लो एंड स्टडी इट्स अ स्लो एंड स्टडी प्रोसेस वंस यू डिसाइड यू विल गिव आफ्टर 2 ईयर्स यू विल हैव ऑल द टाइम आराम से करें And don't take it as a burden. Jab aapko passion hoga na, once you have passion for this examination, definitely you will work hard. You will work hard. So make a proper plan. My best wishes with you.
Thank you, sir. Sir, it is not important. It is not important to think from 8th class, 9th class, so I want to become IAS and all. Because we are not clear our aim at that time. We are not clear about our aim. So if we are thinking from this point also, then also it will be the achievement for us now.
10th class mein mujhe ghar wale dhoondte the ki kahan gaya hai. Like I used to play, I play each and every sport. Main acche profis, matlab I play a lot of games. So 10th tak I was having no idea. 11th, 12th pre-medical test, doctor banna hai. Graduation mein acha veterinarian banna hai, US jana hai, practice karna hai. Aisa nahi hai. If you decide it today, that's more important. ठीक है तो आप इसलिए मैंने कहा ना कि यू लिव फॉर आज के लिए जियो अगर इफ़ यू डिसाइड दैट टुडे आज मैं डिसाइड करती हूँ मुझे लिखना है देन यू शुड बी एब्सोल्युटली श्योर अबाउट देयर शुड बी नो कन्फ्यूजन इट्स अ बाइनरी लॉजिक जीरो और वन आइदर यू प्रिपेयर इट आइदर यू डोंट प्रिपेयर इट यू प्रिपेयर इट वन देन यू हैव टू वर्क फॉर इट आप सिर्फ ये नहीं कह सकते कि मैं सिविल सर्विसेज के एग्जामिनेशन की तैयारी करूँगा या करूँगी फिर आराम से बैठेंगे हाँ तो मैंने डिसाइड कर लिया यू हैव टू वर्क फॉर इट सिर्फ बोलने से नहीं होगा सो वर्क फॉर इट डेफिनेटली विल क्वालिफाई सो थैंक यू सो मच अगर कोई क्वेश्चन नहीं है यू कैन फॉलो माई ब्लॉग मैं दे दूंगा और मेल भी है वट एवर कन्फ्यूजन यू हैव एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ बिकॉज आई हैव प्रैक्टिकली गॉन थ्रू द प्रॉब्लम्स एंड इश्यूज विच स्टूडेंट्स फेस आइदर रीडिंग हाउ टू रीड ए न्यूज पेपर आइदर हाउ टू मेक नोट्स either how to write answers so in detail you can have a communication with me through mail or whatever means we will have and definitely be determined if you decide something today make sure you make an effort in achieving that how many of you have read book The Alchemist I think I don't need to speak more ठीक है उसका जो द ड्रीम ही है सेंटियागो ही स्ट्राइव्स फॉर इट सो आई थिंक आई यूज टू रीड दिस बुक अगेन एंड अगेन बट एंड दिस इन्फ्यूज्ड मी अ कॉन्फिडेंस दैट आई हैव टू अचीव माय गोल सो यू आर ऑन द राइट ट्रैक सो वर्क फॉर योरसेल्फ वर्क फॉर योर फैमिली एंड फॉर योर कंट्री एट लार्ज एंड बी रिलेवेंट टू द सोसाइटी एंड हैव अ पर्पज इन लाइफ एंड स्ट्राइव हार्ड इन अचीविंग दैट पर्पज थैंक यू सो मच
A very good evening to one and all present here. I, Sonal Pandey, feel honored and privileged to get an opportunity to propose a vote of thanks. On behalf of Sri Balaji Society, I express my profound gratitude to our guest, Dr. Bilal Bhat sir, IAS officer, and Ms. Rehmat Bhat ma'am, for sparing their valuable time to guide us for a successful career. We are greatly encouraged by your gracious presence and immensely benefited by your inspiring address. Ma'am, it was lovely hearing your college days experience. It has surely motivated us for the days to come. Sir, we will always remember that we should explore the power in ourselves. This should definitely be done by our generation to achieve our goals. Last but not the least, I would also like to thank our beloved Bala sir for his guidance and providing us such a stimulating and learning environment. Thank you.